Good morning. New face up here, for those who don't know me, I am Lynn Lanning, member of the choir. Been a member of Trinity for, I'm saying, at least 10 years. I am part of the Mission and Outreach Group, and today is our service for the year. The only thing being is my cohorts have all gone gadabout, so it's me. Some of the announcements you've read on the bulletin and things like that. I just wanted to remind you that the gathering resumes on Wednesday at 10 o'clock. Anyone and everyone is welcome for hot drinks and conversation. That's what the gathering is all about, making connections. The office will be closed until the 2nd of January, which is not too far from now. And I wanted to highlight the memo about the Mission and Outreach Group. We are returning to the third Sunday for being Mission and Outreach, and also for Giving Sunday for those who wish to participate. Place your items in the Lazarus cupboard right out here. And we've listed here in the bulletin, and it was on the screen. For January 21st, it's going to be cereal bars, fruit cups, hot cereal, peanut butter, and jam. Now, those particular ones we share with the Operation Sharing that runs out of here, and also the food bank through the Salvation Army. So we split the items. Usually the cereal goes to the food bank and things. So that's it for my announcements. Marge?
Morning. When we were doing the ornaments for the trees, the memorial ornaments, we decided that anyone that wanted to keep their own could take them home, and you could either return them for next year or you can keep them at home, and we'll see what happens. We'll store the rest of them and we'll put them back on a tree next year. So anytime between now and I think they're taking the trees down a week from Monday maybe, help yourself, find your ornament and take it home with you. Thank you.
I'll just do a preparation first before the land acknowledgement. People around the world eagerly anticipate and commemorate the arrival of the new year. Iconic events like the Times Square ball drop in New York City initiate joyous and champagne toasts in communities across the country. In Spain, the tradition involves consuming 12 grapes at the stroke of midnight, symbolizing hope for 12 prosperous months ahead. Meanwhile, the Dutch ignite bonfires using Christmas trees, and in Greece, it's customary to savor St. Basil's cake while searching for the hidden golden coin. As the clock approaches midnight on today, December 31st, many participants revel in the cacophony of noise and merriment, often pausing to sing Auld Lang Syne. However, within the Christian church, its own set of rituals, feasts, and music take center stage. Watch night services and covenant renewals provide an opportunity to break free from old habits, making resolution for the upcoming year. Today, we focus on the act of distinctive covenant renewal as a gift of God, a means of making oneself spiritually open to God's guidance in preparation for another year of faithful discipleship. You can join me with the reading for the land acknowledgement here. For thousands of years, Indigenous people have walked on this land. Their relationship with the land is at the center of their lives and spirituality. As we come into worship, we recognize the Trinity United Church is located on the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee, Anishinaabe, and Arawandrock peoples, who have cared for this land since time immemorial. The community of Ingersoll is represented by both the Between the Lakes Treaty of 1792 and the London Township Treaty of 1796. As we gather, we are mindful of the broken covenants and the need to strive to make right with all our relations. As treaty people, we commit to listen, learn, and work towards justice and reconciliation. Follow as the screen will show, we'll do the call of worship. What a past year this has been.
So much has happened, some wonderful and some very challenging.
In all of this, God's journeyed with us, guiding, healing, comforting, and rejoicing.
We are filled with gratitude for God's presence with us.
Today we are on the precipice of a new year. Together we walk into this future as a faithful community of generosity, compassion, and joyfulness. Let us pray. God of past, present, and future, we give thanks for the gifts of gathering to worship, singing, praying, and hearing how you lead us toward a faith-filled future. At the end of each year, we reflect on all that has been experienced in our lives. Moments of joy and wonder, times of anxiety and confusion. Throughout it all, we are grateful that your covenantal love and guidance. In this new year upon us, we ask you your continued presence as we strive to live out the good news of Jesus Christ, to comfort the lonely, attend to the suffering, welcome the stranger, feed the hungry, and speak for those whose voices are being ignored. In a spirit of togetherness and oneness, we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Today's learning with God's children. I won't put the one young child in their uncomfortable zone and things like that, but I'll encourage everybody to reflect a moment on any moments they felt proud this past year, or a time when someone told them that they were proud of them. Was it accomplishing something that was working? They were working towards? Was it helping family members or someone at school? Was it in sharing something that they had? Those are the things that we all can benefit from sometimes stopping and reflecting and things. Did it feel good to be kind, generous? Or just you did it without even thinking? It's just the way you are. And that's wonderful. For the New Year's upcoming and things like that, let's try to include being kind and or generous a little bit more so than what we have this past year. We're going to change the order of the service slightly right now. We're going to do the passing of the peace now. May the peace of Christ be with you. Of all creation, we know you have a blank canvas of a new year before us, filled with promise and possibility. We also know that the blank canvas of a new year is an illusion. Time ticks on, moment after moment, day after day, month after month. There are times when we are remarkable and generous, yet far too often we can succumb to selfishness and individualism. Forgive us, restore us, and guide us. Be a reminder to us when we seek only to look after our treasured abundance while others are left with so little. In the spirit of your generosity, allow us the courage to share all that we have, all that we do, and all that we have in your name. Amen. Friends, sisters, brothers, hear this good news and live into the promise that you are forgiven. We are now free to create something new. Let us commit ourselves to being open, generous, giving, and always seeking the faithful path before us. Thanks be to God.
First reading is from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12. The visit of the wise men. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born, King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler, who is a shepherd to my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for this child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped over the place where the child was, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. Second reading from Luke 2, 21, verses 1 to 4. The widow's offering. He looked up and saw rich people putting their gifts into the treasury. He also saw a poor widow put in two small copper coins. He said, "Truly, I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all of them, for all of them have contributed out of their abundance, but she, out of her poverty, has put in all she had to live on." Here in the readings.
For creating this service today, I was doing some research and happened to use the United Church website, and I thought it was quite interesting because lo and behold, it said church service December 31st or January 7th. That helped our whole program and things like that. So I was able to pull parts of it, not everything. But this message is actually from the United Church section on the message for this year and things like that. So I've not skillfully prepared this. I am going to do some reading of it and things like that. But the message is 100% right there, and it is heartfelt for me here. So, and it starts like this. Whew! It's finally over. What a relief, right? I don't know about you, but Christmas can be seriously exhausting. Eh, Wanda? Evan? Right after today's time of worship, it's time for Operation Take Down the Christmas decorations, the Christmas tree, the garlands, the ornaments, the decorations. They're all going into storage until next year. Maybe you've already done it. Or perhaps you've got a pile of stale Christmas cookies you're not sure what to do with. Are they for the birds? For the dog? No, better not do the dog. Your unsuspecting kids' lunch boxes? Or still awaiting their fate on a plate? For many of us, it's back to the grind. Kids, maybe grandkids, head back to school, and adults return to work if they had some time off during the holidays. You know, the holiday is over when the routine sets back in. But you know what? I noticed at Christmas we tend to be kinder to friends, families, and strangers, even people we don't necessarily like. Oh. We're a tad more thoughtful, generous,
and considerate. The world just seems a happier place when we're all kinder. We like to get a glimpse of how God intends us to be. It's beautifully captured in part of a poem by Edgar Guest, which goes something like this. Human beings are the finest towards the finish of the year. We are almost like we should be when Christmas season is here. The danger is, once our Christmas stuff is safely packed away, we may also pack away the spirit of kindness and generosity that permeates the Christmas season. That is why it is so important for us to hear Matthew's account of the wise ones seeking out Jesus. After all, this story takes place after the birth of Jesus, and it's a great story. Strangers on a mysterious quest, a jealous king, a guiding star, extravagant gifts. Given in awe and wonder to a young child, and a secret escape. Mary, standing watch all of this unfold, must have been dumbfounded by the generosity of three visitors. How wonderful that these three strangers from the East were not only committed to finding the child, but they were also willing to do whatever was needed to bestow their joyful excitement in finding him and offering the best of what they could give as an expression of their joy. The Reverend Stephen Iverson tells this story about giving in generosity several years ago. A faithful member of the congregation I was serving offered me a gift. In this instance, I was hesitant to accept it for a whole host of reasons, the biggest being that I considered the gift to be far too extravagant and costly for what I knew this person could afford. But I could tell by the expression on this person's face and the joy it radiated from their eyes that they had thought long and hard before offering such an expensive gift. When I tried to dissuade them from giving me this gift, they looked at me and began to sob, almost uncontrollably. Through their cracked voices, they said to me words so powerful that I will never forget. Please do not reject my blessing that I'm giving to you. They were willing to do so, whatever was needed, to bestow their gift on me. The person in this story is reminiscent of the poor widow in the story from Luke. Jesus points her out as an example when she is out of her poverty, put in all that she had. Again, someone willing to do whatever was needed to give and bless. Faithful offerings, gifts of faith, can never be evaluated by the number of zeros contained on the price of the gift. Faithful offerings, offerings of blessings, come from the deep and profound joy in knowing that we have offered, that what we have offered makes a difference and is significant and meaningful. What joy we feel in our hearts when we offer the least is, sorry, that I'll have to do that again. What joy we feel in our hearts when we offer the least is nothing compared to what we offer our best. Doing whatever it takes in order to be generous and share whatever we can is certainly part of the following the way of Jesus. Faith, commitment, and compassion form the bedrock. Faith and commitment and compassion form the bedrock of generosity. Offering meals for those at risk and who live daily with food insecurity. Visiting a neighbor who otherwise lives in isolation. Financially supporting broader communities projects in Canada and around the world are opportunities to practice generosity and growing deeper in our faith. This is the blessing that we get to take part in through our generous mission and service of the United Church of Canada. Mission and Services works to transform lives, inspiring meaning and purpose, and helps in the building of a better world. Let me give two examples. The story one is storytelling is a powerful way to preserve and share history. Theater performance Bunk Number 7 does just that. Bunk Number 7 shares the true story of six boys rioting against the mistreatment and many forms of abuse they received at Edmonton Indian Residential School in St. Albert, Alberta, in the early 1960s. Written by the late Niska MLA Larry Guno, the play is based on his own experience at the residential school and named for his bunk number. The cast features Indigenous youth and young adults, offering a powerful way for the cast and the audience to learn and share the story of residential resilience. In November 1921, not 1921, 2021, the premiere played at Raven Theatre in British Columbia to a full audience. With overwhelming support, the performers went on to a tour of Northwestern BC to share the transformative journey. Your gifts of mission and service open opportunities for storytelling to move forward in a powerful and impactful way. Thank you for your generosity. Mission and service story number two. When we think of education, many of us envision a classroom with books and chalkboard. But education extends far beyond that. Through education, we can learn how the world works and how we work in the world. The Women and Family Service Division at the Church of Christ in Congo provides children with the education and training they need to take charge of their own lives when they leave school. With a combination of traditional education and life skills, they provide each child with the skill set they need to thrive after graduation. Through funding, livestock and seeds are purchased to teach children sustainable agriculture. Older children have the opportunity to assist with the livestock after their classes. They learn to care for chickens and take part in odd jobs in the field. Your generosity through the mission and service helps fund programs inspiring learning and skill for life. Thank you. So as this new year unfolds, we have just experienced a glimpse of how God intends us to be, and if we really want to be change and see change, the question is, what gifts are each of us called to offer? Let us join in singing In the Bleak Midwinter.
Midwinter.
As one year ends and another begins, together we commit to make our difference. Your generosity to this church and to the mission and service assist friends and strangers, those who believe as we do and those who believe differently, neighbors across town and partners across the globe. Your generosity is such a gift. Let's take the offering up now. God, bless these gifts and those offered through PAR or online, that through them we transform lives, inspire meaning and purpose, and build a better world. Remind us that in your giving freely as you do, O God, we embody your own self-giving nature. Thanks be to you. Amen. Today we are going to do the renewal of a stewardship covenanting as laid out in the service that I'm using. I've asked Leanne to join me on this. It's, if you will follow through and join in where you are through this, these words and covenanting, I'd encourage all. As we begin a new year, let us pause and commit ourselves to the spiritual practice of generosity and stewardship. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We're going to sing two verses of Voices United, When We Are Living, and then we'll continue with a few more statements and things, and then finish off after. So.
Thank you. covenant is a promise we make with God and others to live God's way. I ask you now, do you renew the covenant with God and with each other to walk in the way of Jesus?
In the presence of God and one another, we renew our covenant as we give thanks for the example and lasting love of Jesus Christ, who shows us how to generously offer our gifts as an expression of our gratitude and faithfulness.
We remember today's promise made at baptism to support one another and all of God's people as we grow in faith. We commit again to honor and fulfill these promises. Do you promise to participate in the ministry of the church and to use your resources to support others in need, locally and through the mission and service of the United Church of Canada?
We share in the life and ministry of the church. We commit ourselves to share our resources so that we may joyfully live out the ministry that Jesus calls us to follow.
Let us pray. In your image, O God, we are created. Be with us as we reflect on that image in our work and play, as we sing and pray, laugh and cry, give generously and serve others. Help us to accept our responsibility as members and adherents of this congregation and as followers of the way of Jesus Christ. We ask for the encouragement of your Spirit and the energy of your love as we live out this covenant together. Amen.
Pray. God of all time, help us enter the new year quietly, thoughtful of those who are to ourselves and to others, mindful that our steps make an impact and our words carry power. May we walk gently. May we speak only after we have listened well. Creator of all life, help us enter the new year reverently, aware that you have endowed every creature and plant, every person and habitat with beauty and purpose. May we regard the world with tenderness. May we honor rather than destroy. We pray for healing, for strength, for vision, for transformation, for messengers and messages, for community, for acceptance, for making room at our tables, for truth-seeking, for support, for an abundance of generosity, lover of all souls. Help us enter the new year joyfully, willing to laugh and dance and dream, remembering our many gifts with thanks, and looking forward to how we can use them to be a blessing. We offer these in our prayers in the name of the one who will walk with us upon the journey of this new year, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Please join me in the final hymn, Go Tell It on the Mountain. To feed the hungry. As you have been set free, go release the imprisoned. As you have received, give. As you have heard, proclaim, knowing that the blessing of the Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit is always with and is more than you can ever imagine. Amen.